So muscles, they are mainly classified into three types. That is the skeletal muscle, smooth muscles, and as well as the cardiac muscles. So already you know regarding the skeletal muscle. So those muscles, so they are present along with the skeleton. So they are the skeletal muscles. And those are present in the smooth organs. So those are known as the smooth muscles. And those are present in the heart. And those are known as the cardiac muscles. So regarding the functions of muscle, so muscles, so they are play an important role in the producing the body motions as well as stabilizing the body positions, and also they are helpful for the moving and storing of the substance in our body. And also the muscles, so they are play an important role in the generating of heat. So muscle are also play an important role in the equilibrium and as well as the regulations of the locomotions. Among these three type muscle, like skeletal, smooth and cardiac muscle, the skeletal muscles play an important role in the equilibriums or to regulations of the locomotions as well as so motor skill. So today our topic is, that is the introduction to skeletal muscle. So here the muscles, so they are mainly classified into skeletal muscle. So from the figure you can easily know down the skeletal muscles. So they are consist of the multinucleated, okay? So they consist of the certain light and dark band. So due to light and dark band on the muscles, on the skeletal muscles, so they are known as the striated muscles. And the skeletal muscle function, so they are controlled by conscious part of the brain. Okay, the brain having the two part, conscious and unconscious. Okay, conscious is also considered a certain willpower. Okay, so the conscious part of the brain, so that was responsible for the regulation or control the functions of the skeletal muscles. So that's why the skeletal muscle is also known as the voluntary muscles. So in our body, so around 600 skeletal muscles are present in the different parts of the body. So their exact location, so they always present along with the skeletons. And the skeletal muscles, so they can comprise about 40% of the total body weight. Suppose if the person having 100 kg body weight, means so among 100 kg body weight, the 40 kg, so that belongs to the skeletal muscles. And skeletal muscles, so they are play an important tool in that to strengthen the body or protect the body, and as well as involved in the locomotions, because so they are joined with the, that is the bones. So due to contraction and relaxations of the skeletal muscles, so then only the motor skill and the locomotion is possible. For example, if you want to write something, okay, anything, your name or your notes or anything, if you want to write something in your notebook, mean so there is the role of the skeletal muscles. Okay, so what are the skeletal muscle? So they are present in the hand. Okay, so those muscles are skeletal muscle. So their contractions or the tension in those muscle, so that was helpful for the regulations of the writing skills. So that's why the skeletal muscle, so they are play an important role in the regulations of the motor skill as well as the locomotions. So next type of muscle, so those are known as the smooth muscle, and as well as so smooth muscles is also known as the visceral muscles, because so they are present in the, mainly found in the smooth muscles like a GIT, bladder, uterus. So these all are the visceral organs or delicate organs. So that is the exact locations of smooth muscles. Are smooth muscles, So they are involved in the formations of the visceral organ. So due to that reason, the smooth muscle is also known as a visceral muscles. And in the smooth muscle, so there is no, that is the light and dark band is present. Okay, so the smooth muscle, so they do not contain any light and dark band. So due to lack of these band, okay, the smooth muscles are known as the non-striated muscles. So light and dark band is nothing but, so these are the special type of the proteins or contractile proteins. So those are helpful for the contractions of the muscles or participate in the contractions and relaxations of the muscles. But skeletal muscle, so they containing both light and dark band. So due to that they are known as the striated muscle. But smooth muscle, so in the smooth muscle the light and dark band are absent. So that's why the contractions of the skeletal muscle is a more painful as compared to the contractions of the smooth muscles. If anywhere the organs, if they are contracted or smooth muscles in the organs are contracted, means so that is not that much of the painful, because the smooth muscle is contracted, but that cannot be powerful as compared to the skeletal muscle. If the skeletal muscle is contracted, means we will be having the severe pain. Due to that, we are unable to concentrate on the daily work as well as the locomotion and as well as the motor skill, due to only the presence of the striations or presence of the light and dark band. But in smooth muscle, so they are absent. So due to that reasons, so they are also known as the non-striated muscle. And also the smooth muscle function, so that was controlled by the unconscious part of the brain. So there is no willpower, so that was needed, okay, to control the smooth muscle functions. Okay, it is controlled by unconscious part of the brain. So due to that reason, the smooth muscles is known as a involuntary muscles, because it was controlled by the unconscious part of the brain. It means it does not depending upon that much into the brain. But the skeletal muscle contraction, definitely, so that was regulated by the neurons or conscious part of the brain. Okay, so that's why the smooth muscles are known as the involuntary muscle, and skeletal muscles, they are known as the voluntary muscles. So next one is the, that is the cardiac muscles. So as the name indicate, so they are present in the cardia. So cardia is nothing but, it is a Latin word, it is denotes the heart. So those muscles, so they are present in the heart, such muscles are known as the cardiac muscles. And cardiac muscle, so they are single nucleated. Cardiac muscles play an important role in the to create the pressure on the blood. So that was helpful for the movement of the blood from one place to the another place. That was mainly depending upon the pressure on the blood that was created by a cardiac muscles. So that's why the cardiac muscles, so they are play an important role in the, there is a movement of the substance throughout the body or from one part of the body to the another part by moving the blood from one area to the another area. So cardiac muscle, so they are also containing the light and the dark band. So that's why, so these are known as the striated muscles, like a skeletal muscle. So these are also consist of the light and dark band or contractile protein. Due to that reason, so they are known as the striated muscles. And also the cardiac muscle function was controlled by, once again, unconscious part of the brain. Okay, its function, if completely do not depending upon the brain, without the brain, so they are work. The muscles of the organ and muscles of the heart, without the knowledge of the brain, so they will be still their work. So due to that reason, the cardiac muscles is also known as the involuntary muscles, like a smooth muscles. Okay, they are controlled by the unconscious part of the brain, or individually the cardiac muscles, so their work. So depending upon the impulses that were generated by a SA node. So due to this reason, the heart can be isolated, can be transported from one area to the another area, from one person to the another person. So these are the important muscles. So they are present in the different parts of the body. So they are mainly play an important regulations of the motion, transports of the substances, storing of the substances, generations of the energy or heat even. So they are helpful for the equilibriums or balancing of the body. So now we learn regarding the structures of the skeletal muscle. So this is the typical structure of the skeletal muscle. So skeletal muscle is also made up of the group of the cells. Okay, the skeletal muscle cells, so they are the cylindricals. So these cylindrical muscle cells, so those are known as the muscle fibers. So muscle fiber, so these are the nothing but, so these are the single cylindrical muscle cell responsible for the formations of the skeletal muscles. Then this is the epimysium. So this is the outer layer or outer sheath. So that was surrounded by the each muscles, because in our body, so we will be having the 600 different types of skeletal muscles. So each muscle, so they are covered by a connective tissue sheath or layer of the connective tissues. So those are known as the epimysium. Next one is the fascicles. So that is the, it is also connective tissue outside the epimysium. Okay, it is the connective tissue, it is the outside the epimysium. So that was known as the fascia, fascia or fascicles. So next one is the, that is the perimysium. So this is the also made by the connective tissue. So that was covered by a bundle of muscle fiber. So these are the muscle fiber. So they are bundle. So they group together. So those bundle of the muscle fiber, so that was enclosed or surrounded by a connective tissue layer. So that layer, those are enclosed with the muscle fiber or group of muscle fiber, is known as the perimysiums. So this is the perimysium. So it was enclosed by the number of or group of the muscle fiber, and perimysium is also made up of the connective tissue. So next one, that is the part of the skeletal muscle, so that was known as the endomysium. It is also connective tissues and surrounded by each muscle fiber. Okay, each muscle fiber, so that was surrounded by a connective tissue. So that connective tissue is known as the endomysiums. So skeletal muscle is also having the blood circulation. They also require the oxygenated blood. So they are got with the help of the particular type of the arteries and as well as the capillaries. Then venous blood is returned to the veins, or deoxygenated blood can be evacuated or removed with the help of the veins. So the skeletal muscle is also having the good circulation, so with the help of the blood vessels. So this is the tendon. So this tendon is on type of the cartilage. So that was helpful for to form the bridge between the bone and the skeletal muscle. So the skeletal muscle, so they are joined with the different bones. So with the help of the special type of the cartilage, maybe hyaline or fibrous cartilage. So that cartilage is known as the tendon. So any rupture of the tendons, then the paralysis is occurs. That part is unable to the move or to maintain the locomotion. So they due to any injury or any microbial infection, so these tendons are ruptures, are due to there is a more productions of the lactic acid. Okay, due to over exercise. Okay, the skeletal muscle, they can utilize the ATP by anaerobic conditions. But in our body, the glucose are metabolized, they produce the ATP by presence of the oxygen or aerobic glycolysis. But during the rapid exercise, so the muscles immediately they require the ATP, and during the running or exercise rapid, so there is the deficiency of the oxygen. Still, the muscles can got the ATP maximum by going through the glycolysis by anaerobic process. So due to anaerobic glycolysis, the lactic acid is produced. So that lactic acid is responsible for the malfunctions of the tendons. So that's why you always, you can warm up your body before start the exercise. That warm up is helpful for the adjustment of the rate of respiration and cardiac output that can fulfill the demand of the skeletal muscle. Those are helpful for the exercise. If you immediately start the exercise means, so the body cannot be understand. So that's why it need ATP. So that's why the muscle, they can undergo the anaerobic glycolysis. Then the more lactic acid was produced. So that was create the problem in the tendons or muscles. So this is the typical different parts or structures of the skeletal muscle. So now we can discuss regarding the molecular structure of skeletal muscle. So dear students, the skeletal muscles is mainly consist of the particular type of proteins. So those are known as the structural proteins, or as well as, so they are known as the contractile proteins. So skeletal muscle, so they are mainly consist of the contractile proteins like actin, myosin, then as well as the tropomyosin and troponins. So the actin, it is also known as the thin filament, or it is also known as the light band. Okay, so their average diameter is 50 angstroms. So in our body, around 64 millions and average of actin molecule, so they are present in the skeletal muscle. So actin is a protein, or actin is a contractile protein. It is also known as the light band, or it is also known as the thin filament. So its diameter is about 50 angstrom, and the anand average, so the numbers of the actin filament, so in our body is around 64 millions. So another contractile protein, so that was present in the skeletal muscle, so that was known as the myosin. So the myosin is also known as the dark band. So due to this light and dark band, certain striations, so they are appear on the skeletal muscles. So due to that reason, the skeletal muscles are known as the striated muscle. And these two only contractile proteins, so they are play an important role in the contraction and relaxation of the skeletal muscle. So that was required for the movement of the body, equilibriums or balancing of the body. So regarding the dark band or myosin, it is also known as the thick filament. Okay, so the diameter of the myosin is a more. So due to that reason, so they are also known as the thick filament. So anand average, the diameters of the myosin is 150 angstrom, but the number is only 16 millions anand average number of myosin filament. So they are present in the throughout the body or inside the skeletal muscle. So these actin, so myosin, so they are known as the contractile protein. So these two only, so they are decrease the size of the skeletal muscle, or they can relax the skeletal muscles. So when the myosin filament is comes towards the actin filament, so then only the size between or distance between the actin filament and myosin filament, that was decreases. So that was known as the contractions, and relaxation, they are separated. Okay, so they are separated. So that separated period is known as the relaxations. Okay, so another two contractile proteins, so they are present in the skeletal muscle. So those are known as the troponin and tropomyosin. So these are the another two contractile protein or structural protein. So they are found in the skeletal muscles. But in the cardiac muscle, only the troponin is present. But in the skeletal muscle, both tropomyosin and troponin, both are present. So these two proteins, so they are mainly present between the actin filament and myosin filament. So their major function is, so they can avoid the close contact of the actin and myosin filament. So they do not allow the fall of the myosin head on the actin filament. And that period was known as the relaxation, up to whenever these two proteins are active. So they are prevent the decrease the distance between the myosin and actin filament. And that position was known as the relaxation. So due to certain changes in the muscles, so these troponin tropomyosins become inactive. So then only the myosin head fall on the actin filament, then the distance is decreases between the actin and myosin filament, and size is decreases, and that condition is known as the contractions of the muscle or contractions of the skeletal muscles. So here, so due to overlapping of actin and myosin, certain band are forms. Okay, due to overlapping of actin as well as the myosin filament are dark, and as well as light band, they are overlap in certain positions, in certain area. So due to that, so they are responsible for the formations of the band. So here, so these band are, the first band is a H zone, okay, or H band. So this band is formed due to only myosin. It is a lighter band. So this band is appears in the microscope, electron microscope, due to presence of the only myosin. So next one is a, that is the A band. So this A band is a darker band. It is formed by overlapping of actin and myosin filament. That is the overlapping of the actin and myosin filament. A dark band is formed. So that band is known as a band. And regarding the I band, so the I band is also considered as the light band. So that was formed only by a actin filament. So these actin filament, so they're responsible for the formations of the one lighter band or I bands when they are overlap each other in the sarcoma. Next one is the, that was the Z line or Z band. So this is consist of the short elements which can interconnect the thin filament as well as the adjoining sarcomeres. So this is the due to, that is the filament, that is the actin filament. So they're adjoined together. They can join the together. So there forms the one band. So that band is known as the Z band and as well as the Z line. So like that. So these are the various bands. So they are formed due to overlapping of the actin as well as the myosin filament or light and dark filaments. Okay. So they are the AH band, then AI band, A band and Z band. But the main and these component, entire component of the skeletal muscle, they are known as the sarcomere. Okay. So then they are known as sarcomere. So they are consist of the special contrail protein. So those are known as the actin, myosin and tropomyosin and troponin. So now we learn regarding the functions of the skeletal muscle. So skeletal muscles play an important role in the, are helpful for the regulations of the locomotions. So whatever locomotions are there, that is the walking skill, running skill. So these all are considered as the locomotion. That is nothing but movement of the body or human beings from one place to the another place. So that was known as a locomotion. So that was only possible because of skeletal muscle. So they are attached with the bones or skeleton. So due to that attachment, so that can permit the walk. So that can permit the run. Okay. So that is helpful for movement of the objects or subjects from one place to the another place due to the skeleton. So that's why the skeletal muscles play an important role in the regulations of the locomotion. So next one, the skeletal muscle is also involved in the regulations of the respirations. So already you learned from the respiratory chapter regarding the intercostal muscle, extracostal muscle and diaphragm. So these are the muscles, so their contraction and relaxation is helpful for the inspiration as well as the expirations. Okay, so those intercostal muscle, diaphragm and extracostal muscle, so these are the example for the skeletal muscles, or these are the skeletal muscles. So due to their contraction relaxation, so they are permit the inspiration and expiration. So that's why the skeletal muscles, so they are involved in the regulations of the respirations. Skeletal muscle is also acts as a storehouse for glycogen. Skeletal muscle, so they are mainly consist of the certain depot in their structure. So those are known as the adipose tissues. So these adipose tissues, so these are the site for the accumulations of excess of glucose in the form of the glycogen. So that's why the skeletal muscle, there acts as a storehouse for the glycogens. Okay, another one is the skeletal muscle is also helpful for balancing the body. Okay, the balance of the body. So that was due to the skeletal muscle. So that's why the skeletal muscles play important regulations of locomotion, respiration, storehouse. It acts as a storehouse for glycogen or storehouse for the certain lipids, and as well as, so they are helpful for the balancing of the body. So next, so we can learn regarding the mechanism beyond the or phenomena, so beyond the skeletal muscle contraction. So before going to skeletal muscle contraction, we should be learn regarding the period of the skeletal muscle contraction. So dear students, the skeletal muscle, so they are mainly having the two period. One is the contraction period and second one is the relaxation period. Contraction period means the myosin filament is fall on the actin filament, or myosin actin filament, they come close together, or distance or gap between the actin filament and myosin filament, that was decreases, or the size of the skeletal muscle is decreases, and that period is known as the contraction period. And contraction period is helpful for the to regulate the functions of the skeletal muscles regarding locomotions, regarding movement or holding of object or motor skill or even respirations or balancing of the body. So that is due to only the presence of the contraction period. And relaxation period, that is the normal positions of the actin and myosin filament where the troponin and tropomyosins are active. So they are aware the closeness of the actin and myosin filament, and that period is known as the relaxation period. So these are the main two period. So they are present in the each and every muscles, including the skeletal muscles. So next one, so regarding the types of muscle contraction. So the muscle contraction, so they are mainly classified into two types, that is the isometric contraction and as well as the isotonic contractions. So isometric contraction means in which the intramuscular tension is increases, a pressure in the muscle is increases, but the size of the muscle or length of the muscle do not alter. Either muscle is not decrease their size or not involved any change in the size of the muscle, but the tension in the muscle is increases. So that type of contractions of the skeletal muscle is known as a isometric contractions. So example is a holding a book in your hand. Okay, you can hold the larger book in your hand. Okay, certain pressure was created in our hand, but that period, so there is no muscle's length can be altered. Length is the same, but tension was increases in our hand. If the tension increases, then only we are able to hold the large things or book. So such type of period or contraction is known as the isometric contractions. So regarding the isotonic contraction, so here the increases the intramuscular tension as well as the length of the muscle is increases. Okay, the length of the muscle is increases or decreases. Okay, such period of contraction or contraction, such type of contraction is known as a isotonic contractions of the skeletal muscles. Example is contraction and relaxations of the diaphragm during the respiration. So where the length of the muscle was increases or decreases regarding the diaphragms. So that diaphragm size is increases, decreases. So that was play an important role in the inspiration, so as well as the expiration. And that type of contractions of diaphragm is considered as a isometric contractions. So now we discuss regarding the various steps. So those are involved in the skeletal muscle contraction. So dear students, the skeletal muscle contractions was regulated or depending upon the stimuli. So that was generated from the nucleus. If you want to start running, okay, so when your leg is start to running, or any your ear can hear run up, okay, maybe your friend is told to you, you can start the run, we can, or any teachers during the sports activities, so they give the signal to start the run. So that stimuli through the ear, it can reaches to the cerebral cortex, and that cerebral cortex, it consists of the millions, trillions of, or billions of the neurons. So those neurons are stimulated, so those are generated regarding the information what can do by the leg, because leg muscles need to contract, so then only we can able to run, otherwise we are failed to run or walk. Okay, so that nucleus or neuron that was generated the message, so that is responsible for the release of the acetylcholine. So the acetylcholine, it is a neurotransmitter. It was released in a neuromuscular junction, that is the junction between the axon or end part of the neuron and muscle cells. Okay, so that gap is known as the neuromuscular junctions. So during the muscle contraction or during the contraction period, in the beginning, the neuron, it can release the acetylcholine from the, in the neuromuscular junction, from the synaptic vesicles. Okay, so that's why the neuron, so they are play important role in the to initiate the contractions of the skeletal muscles. So due to this reason, the contraction of the muscle is mainly depending upon the conscious part of the brain. So that's why, so they are known as the voluntary muscles. So that released acetylcholine, it can act on the certain type of receptors. So those are known as the nicotine muscular receptors or NM receptors. So these are mainly found in the skeletal muscle. So these muscles only responsible for to initiate the contraction and relaxation of the skeletal muscles. So due to any stimuli, so that releases acetylcholine, it can act on the NM receptor and it can causes the opening of the sodium channel on the plasma membranes of the muscle fiber or on the muscle cells. So due to opening of the sodium channel, the sodium is enter more inside the muscle cell or muscle fiber. So due to that, the concentrations of sodium inside the muscle cell, so that was increases, and that can cause the one condition. So that condition is known as a depolarization. Depolarization nothing but in the resting of the cell, it is having the negative environment, that is the minus 70 millivolt. So due to accumulations of sodium or entry of sodium from outside to the inside the cell or from extracellular fluid into the intracellular fluid, it can responsible for to cause the accumulations of sodium. So due to accumulations of sodium, the positive environment was developed, and that condition is known as the depolarization. And this depolarization is responsible for so release of calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. Sarcoplasmic reticulum, so these are the organelles of the cell. there acts as the stores for the calcium mainly found in the mitochondria. So that sarcoplasmic reticulum, so that can release the calcium due to depolarization, and also the calcium can be enter from extracellular fluid into the intracellular fluid. So like that the calciums can be accumulated. So one molecule sodium exists from the cell during this period and one molecule of calcium can be enter. Okay, then so release of calcium from sarcoplasmic reticulum, it is responsible for to cause the phosphorylations of troponin and tropomyosin. So troponin, tropomyosin, so these are the structural protein or contractile protein. So they are present between the actin and the myosin filament. So they can avoid the, that is the contact or close between the actin and myosin filament. So due to accumulations of calcium, so these tropomyosin and troponin, so they are inactivated, and that stage is known as the phosphorylations of the troponin and tropomyosin. So next, so due to inactivations of the troponin and the tropomyosin, so that is the head of the myosin filament, it can fall on the actin, or actin filament, it can pull the towards myosin head. So due to that, the gap or distance between the actin and myosin filament was decreases. So that was known as the power stroke of the contractions. So due to phosphorylations of troponin and tropomyosin or inactivations of troponin tropomyosin, so the myosin head, okay, so that can fall on the actin filament. Then the distance between or length between the actin and myosin filament, that was decreases, and that is known as a power stroke of the contraction. And in the end of the power stroke of the contraction, the myosin filament, it can loses the ATP. So initially it can consist of the ATP. So due to power stroke contraction, ATP converted to ADP. Then the end of the power stroke, okay, so that ADP molecule from the head of the myosin, so that was loses. So due to loss of the ADP molecule from the head of the myosin, that can allow the attachment of the new ATP molecule on the head of the myosin. So that was occurs in the step 3. Okay, so this the source of the ATP is once again glycolysis. So due to breakdown of glucose or glycolysis, it can produce the ATP, may be aerobic, may be anaerobic. Okay, so that ATP is required for to bind on the myosin filament, and that was helpful for the required for the contractions of the skeletal muscles. So here after the end of the power stroke contraction, so ADP molecule on the myosin head, that was loses, and that can empty place, it was occupied by a new ATP molecules on the head of the myosin filament. And after that, so both the that is the troponin and tropomyosin, so they are activated when the ATP will be the bind on the myosin. So due to that, the myosin filament, so they are detached from the actin filament, or the head of the myosin, it was away from the or detached from the actin filament. So that was known as the relaxation period or relaxations of the skeletal muscle. Then that is the head of the myosin, it was ready for the another cycle for contractions. Okay, so that's why, so here the neurons or conscious part of the brain, so that was involved to initiate the contractions of skeletal muscle through a release of acetylcholine, and acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter, so that was play an important role in the contractions of your muscle. And same acetylcholine in the brain, it was required for the regulations of the memory. And same acetylcholine in the JT glands, so that can enhance the gastric secretion. same acetylcholine acts on the heart, so that was responsible for to decrease the heart rate, okay, or decrease the blood pressure or cause the vasodilation. Same acetylcholine, it was required for to initiate the contractions of the skeletal muscle, so it can bind on the NM receptor and opens the sodium channels. So here the two molecules of sodium enter inside the cell of the muscle, and in the same time three molecules of potassium exit from the cell. So due to that, immediately the negative ions escape from the cell and positive ion sodium, a positive charge ion, enter inside the cell. Immediately the positive energy or environment was developed about plus 70 millivolt. So that was known as the depolarization. So this depolarization responsible for to release up the calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum. So that calcium is required for the to cause the phosphorylations of troponin and tropomyosin, as well as it was helpful for the attachment of myosin head on the actin filament, and also it can cause the phosphorylations of the myosin head regarding ATP is converted into ADP. So then only the myosin head, it can bind to the actin filament, that was known as the power stroke contractions. So end of power stroke contraction, myosin head loses ADP and new molecule of ATP is attached. After attachment of the new molecule of ATP, so these troponin tropomyosins are activated, then the myosin head, it was detached or away from the actin filament, so that was known as the relaxation. So like that, the skeletal muscles, so they are contracted. Okay, so now we can learn regarding the physical properties of skeletal muscles, so as well as important skeletal muscle disorder. So regarding the first property of skeletal muscle, so that was known as the extensibility. Okay, so it is the ability of the muscle to extend when it is stretched. So that is the muscles, so they increase their length. Okay, so that was known as the extensibility property of the skeletal muscle. So that way we can seen through a so these animations. So during the relaxation, so due to attachment of the acetylcholine NM receptor, the muscles is contraction or muscles can show the response. So their size was, length was increases. So that property of the skeletal muscle is known as the extensibility. That is the ability of the muscle to extend when it is stretched. And second property, so that was known as the elasticity. So after contraction, the muscles is returned to its original position. That is relaxation. And that property of the skeletal muscle is known as the elasticity or elasticity. So that is the stretched muscle. Then due to elasticity, so that muscles, skeletal muscles, so they return their original position, and this property is, so next one, that is the excitability. It is the ability of muscle to respond to stimulus or to react to nervous system. The response of the muscle towards the stimulus or stimuli or nervous system, so that property of the muscle is known as the excitability. That is the, they give the response to the neuron, that is the extensibility. So they where the size of muscle is increased, that was known as the muscle extension. Then also they give response to the neuron regarding the relaxation or elasticity, then muscles are returned to the original position. So this is the relaxation and increase the length of the muscle. So due to giving the response to the information came from the neuron, so that property of the muscle is known as the excitability. Next one, that is the contractility. It is the ability of the muscle to contract when it contact with the stimulus. That is the informations from the neuron, release of acetylcholine, various processes occurs. So due to that, the size of the muscle is decreases, or muscle give response to the stimuli. So that property is known as the contractility, where the muscle length was decreases. Then trip, repeatedly stimulation of muscle at a regular interval. So that property of the muscle is known as the trip. Refractory period, okay. So between the period of action potential or information stimuli from the neuron, certain time is there, so where the muscle do not give any response to the stimuli came from the nervous system. Okay, so that period is known as the refractory period, where the muscle are unable to show any type of response, even relaxation, even contraction, that cannot be give any response to the stimuli. Okay, so that period between the two stimuli, so that period is known as the refractory period or recovery period. So that during that period only the muscles are recover to give response to the next stimuli. So what are the period is present between the two stimuli, so where the muscle do not show any reaction or response to the muscle, so that period is known as the refractory period. It is about 30 to 50 millisecond. So next one, so regarding the important skeletal muscle disorders, the first one is the fatigue, that is inability of muscle to contract. So fatigue is nothing but the decrease the energy level in our body, decrease the productions of ATP, so where the muscles are not involved in the contraction. So that contraction is required for the locomotions, regular activities. If you are failed to regulate the regular activity in the normal manner, and that condition is known as the fatigue. It is the conditions of the skeletal muscles where it can show the inability of muscle to the contract, and that is known as the fatigue. Then cramp, painful spasmodic contraction. Okay, the muscles are stay in the contraction period only. So that period or that condition is known as the cramp. So cramp is occur due to once again lack of ATP or lack of the potassium and lack of the elasticity period or relaxation period. The muscles are present in the contraction stage only. So that is known as the cramp. So next one, that was known as the muscular atrophy. It is the conditions of muscle due to motor dysfunction. So due to motor dysfunction, the fluid can be accumulated in the skeletal muscles. Okay, so that condition is known as the muscular atrophy. The muscular atrophy is also create the problem in the regulations of locomotions, because the muscles are failed to generate the tension for locomotions, because contraction of skeletal muscles depending upon the generations of the tension. So due to muscular atrophy, the tension or pressure in the muscle was not generated, and that stage is known as the muscular atrophy. So next one, that is the tetany, wild spasm. Okay, so that condition was known as the tetany, so where the muscles are unable to relax for longer durations. Okay, sometime your neck can be cramped, okay, for longer time. So that is the tetany or wild spasm. Next one, that is the myalgia. It is denoted the muscle pain. If you having any muscle pain means, so that was denoted by the myalgia. Myalgia occur due to deficiency of potassium, deficiency of the antioxidant, deficiency of the calcium, sodium. So due to electrode imbalances or vitamins imbalances or energy imbalances, then there is a pain is present in the muscle. Even increase the lactic acid level in the muscle due to anaerobic glycolysis, then also the muscles having the pain. So that condition is known as the myalgia. So next one, so that is the myasthenia gravis, that is the degenerations of the dopaminergic neuron. Okay, that is the degeneration or failure of the NM receptor in the skeletal muscle, so where the muscles are unable to contract. So that condition was known as the myasthenia gravis. It is a neurodegenerative disorders. So one of the Bollywood famous film star, is Amitabh Bachchan. He is suffering from the myasthenia gravis. So where the muscles of the Amitabh Bachchan, so they are unable to contract or relax because of degenerations on the NM receptor. So where acetylcholine failed to bind on the NM receptor, even that was occurred due to degenerations of the dopaminergic neuron. So those are required for the relaxation of the muscles. So that condition is known as the myasthenia gravis. So last one, muscular dystrophy, degenerations of muscle, simple deteriorations, decrease the number of the skeletal muscle, size of skeletal muscle. So that is known as the muscular dystrophy. So these are the various muscle, skeletal muscle disorders.